Now we visit one of the most successful, prolific women in America, the creative force behind the Barefoot Contessa cookbooks and TV shows. William Brangham went to see Ina Garten at her home in Long Island, New York, and has this second look at her life and career.
Isn't it, this is what I get to do for a living. Isn't it unbelievable?
Fantastic.
Ina Garten is one of the most famous and beloved cooks in America today. Better known as the Barefoot Contessa, she sits atop a culinary empire built on her best-selling cookbooks, with millions of copies sold, a string of hit TV shows.
Just because it's a weeknight dinner doesn't mean it has to be boring.
And a legion of devoted fans.
This is my little secret garden.
We visited Garten at her home and headquarters in East Hampton, New York. We talked in the huge barn she had built next to her house that's now her office, test kitchen, and TV studio, all in one.
This is where the show is shot, and this is where we test recipes, and every morning I walk across the lawn, and I meet the two people, Barbara and Lottie, who work with me, and we just go, okay,
that's
what are we going to do today?
That's the extent of your commute.
That's my commute. It's like 100 yards, I think. Maybe less, maybe 50.
Pretty amazing.
It's pretty amazing. I usually put it right in the middle.
Garten's career began 40 years ago, but at first, she gave no hint as to how she'd evolve. In the 1970s, newly married to husband Jeffrey, Garten was a budget analyst in Washington, D.C.
I was working at OMB, Office of Management and Budget.
For the federal government?
For Ford and Carter. And I worked on nuclear energy policy. How's that for a precedent for the food business?
It makes no sense whatsoever.
I ran from it. And by the late 70s, I thought, I've been working here for 4 years and nothing has happened. And I just didn't feel like I had any impact on anything. And I hit 30 and I thought, I want to do what I want to do. And I thought, I want to be in the food business.
One day, she saw an ad for a specialty food store for sale in the Hamptons, the exclusive beach destination for New Yorkers.
I went home and I told Jeffrey about it, and he said, pick something you love to do. If you love doing it, you'll be really good at it. And so I made her a very low offer, the woman was selling it, and thinking, well, we'll come back, we'll negotiate. We drove back to Washington, and I was in my office the next day, and the phone rang, and she said, thank you very much, I accept your offer. And I just remember going, oh, shit.
What have I gotten myself into?
What have I done?
And that was it?
That was it. 2 months later, I was behind the counter of a specialty food store, trying to figure it out.
The store she bought was called the Barefoot Contessa. That was the nickname of the prior owner.
How's it going?
It was 1978, and this was Garten's very first job in the food industry.
So had you been a cook before?
No.
Not at all.
I never worked in a store. I never worked in a restaurant. I mean, I cooked at home, but that's not really the same thing. I taught myself how to cook when I worked in Washington using Julia Child's cookbooks.
And you've had no training beyond
that? No. No.
That's amazing.
Thank you.
The store was a smash and later moved to a bigger location in East Hampton. After 18 years, she sold the store and tried her hand at a new venture. In 1999, the Barefoot Contessa cookbook was published, and it quickly became a bestseller. 9 additional books have followed, each a bestseller. All contain her trademark simple and accessible recipes.
I think that I had a very clear vision when I started writing cookbooks, what I wanted it to be, and that you would open the book, that you'd look at the photograph and go, that looks delicious. And then you'd look at the recipe and say, I can actually make that, and I can make it with ingredients I can find in the grocery store. I don't think that's changed at all.
Having taught yourself how to cook, does that inform the recipes that end up in your book? Because you're thinking of them not from a professionally trained mind, but someone who did this.
That's really smart. Actually, when I first started writing cookbooks, I remember thinking to myself, what makes me think I can write a cookbook? There are these great chefs who are really trained. And as I started, I realized actually what is my lack is actually exactly right, because I can connect with, cooking's hard for me. I never worked on-
Cooking
the
is hard for you.
It is so hard for me. Anybody that works with me will tell you. It's so hard for me. And that's why my recipes are really simple, because I want to be able to do them.
So let's make the marinade.
Soon, executives at the Food Network came calling.
I use an organic one, but any kind of whole milk or-
And calling,
be good,
and calling.
Yogurt.
It's 2000.
I understand you were reluctant at first to do television.
Reluctant is the understatement.
Really?
I just said no over and over and over again. I just didn't think I'd be good on TV. I just couldn't imagine why anybody would watch it. And Food Network fortunately kept coming back again and again, and they said, just try it. And I thought, well, I'll just do 13 shows and then they'll leave me alone.
And
happily, that was 15
later?
Years later. I'm still doing it. I'm going to show you my recipes and my techniques.
The Barefoot Contessa series is now 13 seasons strong.
You too can cook like a pro.
Her latest version, Cook Like a Pro, shows tips and techniques aimed at helping viewers become more comfortable in the kitchen.
With everything you need to know, from trussing the bird to carving it.
What do you know of your audience? Who is watching it?
You know, there's this moment in time when I really got a vision of who the audience was. I was walking up Madison Avenue, and there was a woman in a big fur coat, and she said, oh, darling, love your cookbooks. And I thought, that's very nice, and I kept going. About a half a block later, a truck driver pulled over and said, hey, baby, love your show. And I thought, that's food. I think my cookbook audience might be slightly different from my TV audience, but I think there are people that are interested in food, and that's everybody. You're doing a beautiful job, I have to tell you.
You're just saying that.
During our visit, Garten showed us a few simple recipes. You can see her demonstrate them on our website. Meanwhile, she says her days are now spent testing new recipes for her upcoming 11th cookbook. It's due in the fall of next year.
I love what I'm doing. I'm really happy doing it, and I hope I can do it forever. And I'm having a ball.